Our top story this evening, the terror threat to Narendra Modi is real and increasing as the elections get closer. Yesterday, Headlines Today reported on the Delhi police searching for Indian Mujahideen Fidayeen suicide bombers who had Modi in their sights. Today, the Uttar Pradesh anti-terror squad have two men in their custody, different from the ones identified by Indian Mujahideen operative Tehsin Akhtar. If sources are to be believed, these men are the real thing. Having received top-level training in Afghanistan, police officially are downplaying the arrest, but we have the inside track from the Intelligence Bureau.
A string of successes for the security agencies. First, it was Yasin Bhatka last year. Then Pakistani terrorist Mohammad Waqas, followed by Tehsin Akhtar, and now two more Pakistani terrorists arrested by the anti-terror squad, this time of the Uttar Pradesh police. The breakthrough came here, very close to the Gorakhpur station late Wednesday night in a hush-hush operation by the UP anti-terror squad. An operation so secret that even senior police officers in the district had no idea what was happening.
उसने पर इन लोगों ने बताया कि इन्हें उत्तर प्रदेश के पूर्वी क्षेत्र में किसी माकूल स्थान पर निहत्थे फोर्स के समूह पर AK-47 एवं पिस्तलों से अंधाधुंध फायरिंग कर हमला करना था.
It is the information which came out during interrogation which has alarmed the central intelligence agencies. The suicide bombers came from Karachi via Muscat and Kathmandu, and they had an unarmed individual as their target. Moreover, they had been trained by Tehrik-e-Taliban in Afghanistan for this purpose. They had also received advanced terror tactic training in carrying out attacks at public places.
The latest information has sent the security agencies in a tizzy. What's more, there are indications it's not only Pakistani terrorists that endanger the BJP's prime ministerial candidate Narendra Modi, but domestic terror as well. A cylinder bomb was recovered at a small railway station between Gaya and Mughal Sarai. Naxals blew up two mobile towers in the Gaya district just hours before his rally in the city. Security forces are, however, taking no chances.
Massive security deployment has been put in place in Sasaram because this area is a Naxal infested zone. At the outer circle, there are metal detectors that have been put up. That's the outer ring where the metal detectors have been put up, and frisking is taking place. Each and every person is being frisked before allowing him inside the ground. After Tehsin and Waqas's revelation that Narendra Modi was on the hit list and he could be the terrorists could be trying to eliminate him through human bombs, that is why the security agencies are taking no chance.
But with the issue being Modi, reactions to the terror threat are divided along political lines.
As of now, the UP police does not concede that the terrorists had a specific target or that they had sneaked in to disrupt the Lok Sabha elections. But the very fact that the ATS intercepted the two alleged terrorists with a huge cache of arms and explosives clearly shows that the police is now trying to downplay the entire terror plot. With camera person Harish Kantpal, this is Amir Haq in Lucknow for Headlines Today.
Editor Strategic Affairs Gaurav Savant is with me live for more clarity on this, because we've been hearing two sides to this very controversial story. Gaurav, the UP anti-terror squad saying there were no specific politicians or rallies on the target by these two Pakistani terrorists who were arrested today. But we've got inside information from our sources in the Intelligence Bureau and other agencies, don't we, that that was precisely what their intention was.
Well, multiple arrests that have taken place in the past week, and the interrogation not just of the Indian Mujahideen India head, but also a large number of other terrorists and at least two sleeper cells that have been busted, have given both the Intelligence Bureau and the Delhi Police Special Cell reason to believe that the BJP's Prime Ministerial candidate Narendra Modi was one of the major targets of the Indian Mujahideen.
Yeah.
Of course, they're not ruling out other politicians in the country. They're also not ruling out political rallies of of various parties, what they're saying is that these terrorists have been told by their trainers in Pakistan to target the election system, the election process in India, to target the BJP's prime ministerial candidate and other leaders, and also ensure that there is a reign of terror across the country. Now, the arrest of Waqas and then Tehsin have been a major shot in the arm for the security forces.
Yes.
And this has, as you know well, Shiv, this has bust up, you know, you've broken the back of the Indian Mujahideen in India as far as the terror masterminds is concerned, because the security forces were going after them.
Yes.
Only one man had information about all the sleeper cells, and that man is now in police custody. There's major mopping up operations that are still on.
Right.
But is Pakistan directly in touch with other sleeper cells? Are they still out to target political rallies? Will the mopping up operations continue unhindered, especially in election season? Is the biggest challenge for the security forces for the moment.
Thanks very much, Gaurav. And security will be beefed up this election season with multiple alerts about the possibility of threats to politicians and suicide attacks at political rallies, as Gaurav has reported this week. Thanks very much for that update.